He will show you things to come. Good things. The Lord's going to show us his good plans. So many people in our culture, people who are in leadership, pastors are struggling with fear, and it's a big deal. I mean, right now, I think so many people are concerned about the future, and there's a duality to this. You know, life doesn't tolerate a vacuum. So, you know, sometimes we're trying just to get the bad stuff out, but if you're not putting the right stuff in, it doesn't really work. You end up defaulting back into this rut, getting stuck. You end up defaulting back into this ditch of concern and anxiety, as Judge was talking about in the middle of the night. I know some of the folks listening right now are feeling that, where in the middle of the night, they're suddenly being awoken by, what about this? And what are you going to do if this doesn't happen? I've talked with some great pastor friends of mine who are telling me, Stephen, I'm concerned. Like, all the things we've done in the past, none of that's working. What are we going to do? But you know, the good news is God has a plan. God's got a future for us, and Jesus is still Lord. He's still King of Kings. So I think one of the secrets in going forward is we got to do a little bit like what Paul did in Philippians 3, verse 13. He said, this one thing I do. You know, when Paul the Apostle says, here's one thing I do, I pay attention. I'm thinking, what's the one thing that Paul's doing? He said, here's the one thing I work at, I strive at. He said, letting go of the past and reaching forward into the future, into what God has for us in the future. And I think sometimes as Christians, we almost think that that's sacrilegious, like that's a bad thing, letting go of some of the things that worked so well back in the 90s or in the early 2000s or even in, you know, 2018, that worked so well. And I think sometimes people think maybe it's disrespectful to God to let go of what worked yesterday. But I think that's part of the process. God, who makes all things new. You know, the Bible says in Psalm 118 that God is the one that gives us a new day. We celebrate and we rejoice because this is the day that the Lord has made. Well, I can't have Monday or Tuesday unless I let go of Sunday. And I think that's where we're at right now as a family, as a Christian culture. We're letting go of the past and we're reaching forth unto the good things that God has before us. And so that helps us deal with the vision issue. But to deal with the fear issue, we need the Holy Spirit's help. You know, Jesus said very specifically in John 16, he said, the Spirit, the Comforter is going to come. That's what he called him, the Comforter with a capital C. And he said, the Comforter is going to come. And you guys, here's what he's going to do. Here's how he's going to comfort you. He's going to lead you into all truth, and he's going to show you things to come. Now, if you ask any of the CEOs right now, if you ask any of the great leaders in our country, what's the thing that's keeping them awake at night? It's what's coming. Everybody wants to know what's coming because change is happening so fast, so furious. Everybody's trying to figure out, how do I get ahead of this? All the pastors in the country are trying to figure out what's coming. What am I going to get ready for? How am I going to handle this? Well, this is what the Holy Spirit is an expert at, showing us things to come. And if right now you're watching TCT and you're concerned about your future, this is what the Holy Spirit is an expert at, showing you things to come. And that's how he comforts us. He leads us into all truth. And Jesus said specifically, this was in John 16, 13, he said, he will show you things to come, good things. The Lord's going to show us his good plans. So how do I overcome fear? How do I overcome the anxiety? By meditating on God's good things, his good plans for my life, for our ministry, for our country, for our world, good things to come.
Hello, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video. To see more videos like this, be sure to hit the subscribe button below to get all of the latest content from TCT Ministries. We would love to pray alongside you for God's blessing in your life. So email your prayer requests to prayer@tct.tv or click the link below to submit your request at tct.tv. God bless you, and we want to thank you for watching.